don't worry about the cameras. Just obviously concentrate on her.
Yeah.
Number one, let's get trotter off. Like when you start off, that the hardest part of that track is from the on gap to around the top there, because it didn't get watered properly. So trotter off to halfway down the back, then get over her neck, and then pick it up from just before, just start three quarter, just before the just before the on gap. Yeah. So trot her right up to that, up to the 12 on the sort of sand, if you can. Just get over next. She'll think she's pace working.
Yeah.
And then just start to pick it up to, you know, three, like 1400 is just there. So we only pace work across here. Just let her bowl down the back and then just let her ease up slowly. Go right into the back straight and we'll walk back home quietly. Yeah. Not easing much, she's pretty willing, isn't she? Ooh, the girl. I just want to make sure she's going to wander back quietly, I'm sure she will. This is the part I like about her best, she wanders back and she doesn't give a shit. This is partly why she's such a good horse, I reckon.
What do you reckon, mate?
Yeah, good girl. Nah, I'd say we're pretty much perfect now.
Cool, perfect, yep,
ideal.
We've just twinked the track work a little, where we've done a little bit more mileage pace work days, just to try and get it to mellow a little bit more in the early and the middle part of stages of the race. I think we can do it. Keep the pace was very similar. And she won an Oaks, admittedly aided by a good ride from Opie Bossom, but Jason Bell's well capable of doing that as well. From the perspective of Keep the Pace, she was a triple Group 1 winner. I'm just not sure she could have put a performance in like Jennifer Eccles did in the Lowland Stakes. She's an incredible filly. She's just very willing in track work. We only gallop her twice a week for that reason. We feel if we gallop her three times a week, she'll probably do a little bit too much on the training track. So the times are quite remarkable, considering trying to get her to go as slow as possible, obviously to get her relaxed to run the mile and a half out. I think we're taking her out of her comfort zone. The likelihood of her being asked to run a mile and a half again is very low. She was so dominant in the last couple of races, we're likely to get away with it. There's a laundry list of great fillies over the years that have run the Oaks trip out and never been able to run the mile and a half again. There's been no indication of any fatigue. In fact, even watching her work this morning, of course, she seems as confident and as competitive as ever. It's always in the back of your mind, and the first instinct that there's something not quite right, she leaves a little bit of feed or she shows any signs of not being happy, then I'll ring Adrian straight away, we'll have a talk about that, and her campaign will cease. But at this point, probably her last win was her best one.
And Jennifer Eccles put three or four lengths on them here. From Loire, Showbiel battles on and then unlaced, but have a look at this brilliant little filly go. And down to the line, Jennifer Eccles will win the Lowland and win it with a leg in the air. Brilliant performance.
I doubt I've had any horse put in a performance quite like that. They just can't race that aggressively. It appeared that Jason was struggling to hold her throughout the race and then finish it off, let alone sprint away from two quality fillies. How great is it when you get 60 people in the birdcage singing a song like that? And it just adds atmosphere to the races, which has been sadly lacking for a while. A lot of people, of course, watch horse racing on TV. But to get bums on the seats at the races, great for the clubs, terrific for us, and you just have to enjoy it. One of our primary goals, Adrian and I have been talking about for some time, is that Filly of the Year series. And I know Probabil hasn't been there, and Two Illicit followed a derby path. But with Loire, even Travelling Lights won a Group 1. This is an outstanding bunch of three-year-olds when you throw in Dragon Leap and Catalyst, Colts and Geldings. To be the filly of the year in a year like this, it would be something special. And to have that honour at this particular year is major for us. So obviously we're hoping we can justify that by winning a Group 1 on Saturday and putting that final mountain to bed, because she's won three Group 2s now. And apart from the Australian win, which everyone would love, to win the Oaks is the ultimate prize. I really feel that she could go out and do the same thing as she did in the Island Stakes. Or there's that little inkling in the back of your mind when you watch a horse like Dragon Leap, who's a classy horse with a good turn of foot, such as Jennifer Eccles, just find that last 200 and a mile and a half a struggle. I'm hoping that doesn't happen. I don't think it will, but that's a chance too. So she's not the sort of filly who's going to go out there and fade away and run no good. So she's going to be competitive. You know, we've probably got, as we have all the way through, perhaps the filly with the best turn of foot in the race. Hopefully she can save herself to use that.